Hello everyone, Xenozim here. Welcome back to Let's Play Hyrule Warriors Definitive Edition. Last time, well, we were being evil. But this time, it's time to switch up. Now, as the Master Sword's chosen warrior, Link, we start what we're going to be playing with the weapons that he starts with. Well, the weapon type, at least. Sorry about that. Oh. Yeah, that's all of it. But let's move on to the badge system. Since Link is the best option for this, this is how you get new combos, spirit duration, special gauge, more special gauge, how to inflict injuries while the guard's up, their gauge. Yeah, as you can see, for these. However, we're going to be using the Hallion Sword. Let's roll. The same nightmare keeps haunting me. No omen, perhaps. A dark times ahead for Hyrule. Dark times? If that is indeed true, we must locate him. We must find the reborn spirit of the hero. We will find no fully realized heroes here. We'd be wiser looking somewhere else. Your Highness, a horde of monsters has marched towards Hyrule Castle. Impa, prepare the troops for battle. Oh, isn't that the princess? What's she wasting her time with us for? So I guess we wait to hear what happened. Hey Link, what do you think you're doing with that sword?
Hordes of monsters began laying siege to the kingdom of Hyrule. Princess Zelda led a valiant defense against hopeless odds. News of the Hyrulean army's imminent defeat reached the cadets at the Knight's training yard. As the elite troops fell in battle, Hyrule's trainees were left to wait helplessly inside the castle walls. Despite the odds, one young knight took took up his simple training sword and chose to fight. This brave young man was named Link. Compelled to act, he rushed to the monster-ridden battlefield to assist Zelda and defend Hyrule.
Now, let's do just that. Boom, bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. So, Link, basic fighting style, not bad. Just a good all-around fighting style. Thanks, M-Proxy. Who are you? That Link, huh? What's your name? What's it mean? Where are you from? Nice sword. Didn't even say my name. Banner four opens, and we find our foe. Get out of my way, boy. And Volga runs. Bum brum brum dum dum bum brum ba brum brum ba brum brum ba ba ba. Sorry, I love this. Thank you. beat him back. We'll run down here. And this is where a chest cutscene would be, but we don't have one. And this is where the bombs would be if we hadn't collected it. And we can switch to Zelda. So, let us talk about Princess Zelda. Zelda's rapier, because she has multiple fighting styles like Link, is actually probably one of my favourites, but it got better in Fire Emblem Warrior when Marth started using it, because it just ended up having some power that it didn't have before. Plus it didn't have this move, which while is fun, I prefer how quick Marth is. Okay. Full combo, gives us a bit of light. Okay, I'm gonna send Zelda down here. Gonna send Link up here. Instead, we want to actually run over here. For one reason. Because there's actually a bonus objective tied to this. Yeah. And this will actually help a bit. We actually don't need to worry about the one in the right. And finally, We have a new fighting style. New character and a fighting style. Now we can switch to Impa, who is taking a bit of damage. Now Impa with the Giant's Knife is actually weird, in my opinion. For Fang Steel's not that terrible, but the problem is that thanks to how enemies, at least hard enemies, are handled, we can't even get like some of our most satisfying moves. Like, I'm trying to, but I can't. Anyways, Impa will head down here. God. Use the magic circle. I wish that was as destructive as the game likes to portray it. Impa, get over there. Now we can heal up, if the game allows me. We're not going to see that cutscene again. Because that's not the second King of Angle one I want to show. Still really cool to see. Yes, enjoy the time, King. This is a proper dialogue if you actually take him out first. We are gathered. Sorry about that. Delivery came in, so I had to pause for a bit. energy. Energy coming up. Oh my god. Keep slapping his tail. Fine. Let him continue going, because I have one reason to allow him to continue to go. Arvan. Yeah, I'm just gonna let you burp up fire this time. Because this actually, funnily enough, has a plot relevance. Yes, him breaking through a wall has plot relevance. I am trying. What do you think I'm doing? Because now it's in a position where I feel. Dude, slap in the neck. Oh, come on, Impa. All right, you're not targeting King Dodong. Really? Come on. I know he's advancing toward the cast peak. Would help if he actually started to breathe. Which feels weird to say. Why is he... Yeah, what? There you go. Now eat bombs. Boom, boom. Okay, he's still up. Down you go! Cut right through. Well, that's rush. No.
The Triforce is the harmonious union of power, wisdom, and courage. It has been the object of countless battles between the forces of light and darkness. Each time the Triforce fell into the clutches of evil, Hyrule was plunged into misery. But in every age, a hero, clad in green, would restore peace to the land. During one of these dark times, the legendary hero split the spirit of evil into four fragments, sealing each away to finally break the cycle of destruction. Three of the fragments were scattered across time and space. The final fragment was sealed in a sacred temple built upon holy ground, imprisoned by the blade of evil's bane.
And with that will actually be our episode for this session of recording. Next time, we'll be playing Vashika Tribesman. However, we'll be going over a new character. So, there's that. Anyways, I'll be seeing you guys for that. Xena and Zuma, signing out. I don't know why I'm clicking my fingers.